Hello Python programmers, once again welcome back to another video in Python tutorials with Arshad. In our previous videos we had completed these 5 questions. We had discussed each and every question. Now in this video we will discuss what are exceptions in Python and we will see what is exception handling in Python. So I am opening a Visual Studio Code now. I am creating here new Python file named as q22.py. Okay, now here I am just declaring a variable named num and I am taking input from user in integer format and I am providing a text as enter a number. Now after that I am printing this num variable. This will take input in integer format and that input will be stored inside that num variable and we are trying to print this num variable. Now I am running this program. Now you can see here it is asking me enter a number. Now I am entering here number as 56. Now you can see here it has printed 56 now. This is what will happen, right? We all know this. Now I am running this program once again. I am here clearly mentioning as enter a number. But if anyone enters strings instead of numbers, then what will happen? Okay, we will try this. If I just take a random word here and if I hit enter, then you can see here it has written me error. Okay, this is what will happen, right? Because here we are typecasting this num variable. If anyone enters string, then we can't perform typecasting. So you can see here it has written me a value error. It is saying that invalid literal for int with base 10. Then here for solving this problem, we need to enter only integers. But if normal person enters a string value instead of entering an integer, then he cannot understand this error, right? So here I want to avoid this kind of errors. I don't want this kind of errors to be shown. Instead of showing this big errors, I just want to show don't enter text, just enter numbers. So how can we do that? Now these errors are known as exceptions and we are trying to avoid these errors now. For that our Python provides us two amazing keywords known as try and except. Now I am just saying that try. After the try we will use this colon for indentation and in the below line it is important to provide 4 spaces. With the help of this try keyword, if any error occurs then it will enter into except block. Now the syntax here is after this except keyword we need to mention the name of error. In this case we are having a chance to get value errors. Because if anyone enters string instead of entering integers, then it will return as value error. So I am just saying that except value error, then enter into this except block and just print don't enter strings. After that print enter integers. Okay, now I am running this program once again. Now here if I enter string value, then you can see here it has written me don't enter strings, enter integers. Okay, it is good. This is what we want, right? We don't want to show this big error. We just want to show a single line which will say user don't enter strings, just enter integers. Okay, it's good up now. But while dealing with some big projects, if you don't know what kind of error will occur, then you can use this except keyword alone. You don't need to mention this error name also. It also will work. Now you can check if I run this program and if I enter another string value, then you can see here it has written me the same output, which is don't enter strings, enter integers. And the reason behind using this error name is because then only you will be able to know that what kind of error is occurring. Now instead of this value error, if I say index error, then it won't enter into this except block. It will again return me the same value error. With the help of that also we can consider that here another error is occurring, not index error. Okay, if you are able to understand what I told just see here. Now I am removing these two statements. Now here I am declaring a variable named lst which will store a list of values. Now inside this list there are 7 elements of percent. Now we know that in list indexing starts from 0 and here there are 7 elements present. So it will start from 0 and it will end at 6. Now if I try to print the index number 7 then it will return an error. Now if I run this program then you can see here it has written me index error. It haven't entered into this except block because after this except keyword we are mentioning only value error. So instead of entering into this except block it has written me index error. Now instead of this value error, if I say index error and if I run this program once again, then you can see here it has written me that don't enter strings, enter integers. Okay, it has just executed the stuff present inside this print statement. Now we can change this also. Now I am providing here text as invalid index number. Now if you run this program once again, then you can see here it has written me invalid index error. Okay, I hope you understood this concept. Okay, now can we use else along with this try and except block? Yes, we can. Now here I am just saying that else, and inside this else block I am just printing that program executed successfully without any errors. Okay, with the help of this print statement only, you will be able to understand that our Python will enter into this else block if there are no errors. Now if I run this program, then you can see here it has just written me invalid index number. Now I am changing this index number from 7 to 6. Now if I run this program once again, then you can see here it has printed me 6. After printing 6, it has written me program executed without any errors. Now I will explain you this code once again. Now here we are trying to print the value present at index number 6. So here the value present at index number 6 is 6. So first of all it has printed a 6. As we know here there are no errors, so it will just ignore this except block. After that it will finally enter into the else block and it will execute the stuff present inside this else block. And here we are just printing that program executed successfully without any errors in this else block. So it has written us that statement also. Okay guys, that's all about exception handling in Python. Here we will use three kind of keywords which are try, except and else. By default our Python interpreter will enter into this try block. After that it will execute the stuff present inside this try block. If any error occurs, then it will enter into this except block and it will execute the stuff present inside this except block and it will ignore this else block. If there are no errors, then instead of entering into this except block, it will enter into this else block and it will execute the stuff present inside this else block. Okay guys, that's all in this video. We have seen what is exception handling in Python. I hope you understood this video. If you like this video series of Python tutorials with Archer, then share this video series with your friends also. And also don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel Programming with Archer. Hit this bell icon to get latest updates. And finally, thank you for watching till end. I will see you next time with another.